sick and without your help, he will not last. Mary and Martha watch their brother die. They wait.
That was a classic from our friends Karen Peck and New River. Welcome to NQC's American Gospel. I'm Jim Brady. This is my good friend Joseph Habedank. It's going to be a great day.
It's going to be a great show because this featured artist just so happens to be a group that you are so familiar with, and that's our good buddies, the Booth Brothers.
Oh, yeah.
And our good friend Matt Fouch caught up with them right before they hit the main stage.
We are here at the 2019 National Quartet Convention, and we are actually out here in the exhibit hallway.
This is it.
Folks are having a blast this week at NQC, and I am standing here with the Booth Brothers. Guys, we are so glad to have you back here at NQC this year. We're thankful the Booth Brothers are with us. You guys are doing something extremely special this year. We got a 30-year reunion right here at NQC. Talk about that and how special it is for you guys.
This is the first time all the members of the Booth Brothers have been on stage together.
Wow.
So it's never happened before. We're only missing one. We do consider our Uncle Charles, who was with us at two different periods of time for 6 months each. And he's home with the Lord now, but everybody else, Dad, Joseph Smith, Jim Brady, and who was the other guy?
Paul.
So got the whole kit and caboodle together.
That's awesome. Ronnie, 30 years, man. Can you put that into perspective for you? Just, I'm sure there's been many moments sitting at home or on the bus that you're just kind of hit you every now and then.
Well, we had our nose to the grindstone for so long, for so many years, it was just push, push, push. And it's like you wake up one day and you're trying to comprehend it's been 30 years.
Yeah.
And because we never want to stop growing. We want to keep growing better, obviously, in our walk with Christ, but as musicians, as artists, and the creativity and what's more effective to the audience, you know, what really hits the heart. We're constantly striving for that. And it is. You wake up one day and you think, my goodness, 30 years has gone by. How's that possible? You know?
Yeah. Well, I know you guys got some great things planned for the 30 year. I don't know what they are, but I know you guys are planning some great things. What's the one moment you guys are really looking forward to during that reunion?
I think we're going to do one song with everybody together. And when we first started, Easter Sunday morning, 1989, in Brandon Fellowship Baptist Church outside of Tampa, Dad, Ronnie, and I sing Because He Lives. So I shouldn't give away the finale, but it's going to be Because He Lives with every member, and Ron Sr. is going to be up there with us.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Paul, you've been in this group for the last 5 years.
5 years.
And so talk about that experience, man, just being on the last 5 years of this 30-year run.
It's been a great experience. I'll tell you one thing that's amazing. It's 5 years has gone by, and I'm not just saying this to be nice, because I've, you know, you've been places where honeymoon can be over really quick, you know, if you get there. But I'm telling you what, at 5 years here, this is my home, and this is, it's still just excited to be here as I was day one when I got the call. My wife and I were pogo sticking in the kitchen. So yeah, still happy. Yeah.
That's awesome.
So yeah, there are, and in fact, you'll notice they're so easy to get along with. That's why there'll be such a short roster of past members, because they're too easy to get along with.
Yeah.
That's the goal.
That's right. I don't know how many reunion tours there would, or reunion concerts there would be, that would have as few members on stage.
After 30 years.
Yeah, yeah. After 30 years.
I never thought, good point, Paul. Great job. We can stay another 5 years.
Hey, thank you.
Jesus loves me. He really loves me. And I guess that says it all.
I don't know just how I'm going to tell it. Tell the world just how I feel. For I would need the language of the angels to say the things I'd really like to say. Even then this human tongue would falter, for eloquence somehow just isn't mine. I only want to say how it makes me feel today to know that I am His and He is mine.
Jesus loves me, and I guess that says it all. It says enough to satisfy my soul. Jesus loves me, and I will not ask for more. I know He cares for me, and that says it all.
Like to tell about the prayers He's answered, and tell about my blessings one by one, of how I live because He lives inside me. How even now my life has just begun. If I had 1,000 years to tell it, still cannot begin to really say
how much it means to know that the one who loves me so is Lord of lords and King.
New music this year. We got an Aether video and CD. Give us a little bit about that and why it's important to you.
Well, we wanted to sing about different subject matters that we haven't done in our past catalog, and we want to sing about the home, about marriage as God intended marriage to be, and about other subjects. And we found these subjects best written in classic country songs. And you ask any one of our military personnel who's been overseas for 6 months or a year, Hey, is it good to be back home again? You better believe it is. Even better, how many of our missionary friends have been out there on the mission field and they get to come home for a while? Now, home is very significant, and we wanted to sing about songs about home and about the importance of a strong home. And then marriage, you know, the way God intended it to be. We recorded Randy Travis's Forever and Ever Amen, dedicated it to our wives, because we made a vow, and before God and before man, these are the women we're going to be faithful to, and that means something. Whether society agrees with it or not, God says it does, and that's what matters.
You guys are going to be taking stage a couple times here at NQC in the next couple days.
Yeah.
What song are you most looking forward to singing for the folks here this year? You got so many hits.
Well, honestly, the one I'm looking to for we're going to do tonight is Mosey Lister's His Grace is Sufficient.
Yeah.
And I always love that song, Matt, because I know it's applicable to everybody.
That's right.
Everybody in the room needs grace in one form or another. So,
that's right.
So you know it's effective for everybody.
For sure. What about you, Ronnie?
Probably, I would have to agree with that. His Grace is Sufficient. And then Mosey Lister's classic, Then I Met the Master.
Yeah.
Honestly, that's the one I want to be remembered by.
Yeah.
Larry Goss arranged that, and we waited for several years, not only until we had the opportunity to work with Larry, but we had the budget,
yeah.
You know,
yeah.
to work for that, because
oh, yeah.
we didn't want to hold anything back. That song needed, and we threw it all at it, and Larry came up with a great arrangement.
Yeah.
And,
he absolutely did.
That's the one I want to be remembered by.
Well, yeah. I mean, you're just saying that I can't help but believe that will be a song that you will be remembered for, because it's so good. Paul, what about you, man?
I was going to say the same thing. I'm at the Master. That every night when we get that line, I belong to Him,
yeah.
I pretty much cry every night. That's an overwhelming thought. I belong to Him.
Amen.
And
yeah.
so every night that we get to that line, like I'm doing right now, just thinking about it, I tear up. So.
Yeah, and I think we all, as artists, have that song, that line, or whatever, mm-hmm. and it doesn't matter how many times you sing it, it still can speak to you every night when you get up there and you sing that song. Guys, thank you for your time
thank
tonight.
You, man.
I know you're going to have a great time the next couple days. Guys, thank you for watching. We're here in the exhibit hall, NQC. Y'all have got to come to NQC. We're having a fantastic time. Take care and God bless y'all.
Hey, that's a lot of fun from my buddies, the Booth Brothers, written by Mosey Lister, a legendary songwriter. Can't get any better than that.
You really can't. I love that song. And Speaking of great songs, Gerald Wolfe's Gospel Music Hymn Sing is coming up next with one of my favorite hymns. Here is At Calvary.
Years I spent in vain. Mercy there was great.
I know you're enjoying yourself today. If you're enjoying this, you've got to attend the National Quartet Convention. You'll be glad you did. You can find us on social media, Facebook, Twitter, on the web at nqconline.com. Check us out. You'll be glad you did.
One of the most talented families in gospel music is the Isaacs. And here they are to close out our show today with a Dottie Rambo classic, He Ain't Never Done Me Nothing But Good. Thank you for joining us once again right here on NQC American Gospel.
Thank you.
Christian Healthcare Ministries presents gospel music's most spectacular event, the National Quartet Convention. Returning to a premier vacation destination, Pigeon Forge, Tennessee. Headlining the main stage at the LeCon Center are The Hoppers, Greater Vision, Jim and Melissa Brady, The Mark Trammell Quartet, The Collingsworth Family, The Booth Brothers, and more.